So there are a couple unique ways to unlock a Tesla Model 3. You have your normal keycard thing that you place next to the door to unlock the vehicle. These black cards come with the car. They're the exact same size as a credit card. You can also get a key fob with a button in the center that unlocks and locks the car. These are quite a bit more expensive, around $150, instead of the $10 that it costs to replace the small keycard. The easiest way to unlock your car, though, is with the Bluetooth connection on your smartphone and the Tesla app. It just happens automatically when you walk up to the car. Personally, I think the shape of this keycard is quite obnoxious. I've seen people try to awkwardly attach it to keychains. To be honest, I don't think you actually need the whole thing. I vote we hack into the card, see how it works, and try to physically modify it into something else. The embedded chrome lettering can be removed, but the adhesive is strong enough that I bet it'll be years before the letters fall out on their own. And with how inexpensive these cards are to replace, it's a non-issue. Cutting into the card reveals something interesting. The card isn't just plastic. There is technology in here, taking up more space than I anticipated. All along the edge of the card is copper wiring. This particular card is from my buddy Ben over at Teslanomics. I sure hope he doesn't need this back, because I'm pretty sure the thing I just cut was the antenna. The Tesla Model 3 keycard uses something called RFID to communicate with the car by tapping it next to the pillar next to the car door. The keycard needs to be within an inch or two of the door panel, so there shouldn't be any obstructions between the card and the car. If my antenna theory is correct, the copper wiring should run along the entire edge of the card, which indeed it does. Each cut exposes a little bit of the antenna wiring. The antenna should circle back into a little chip in the center somewhere, and since I can see a slight indention in the card itself, it should be here in the corner. And there the little guy is. Successfully destroyed and chopped in half, this method of tearing down the card wasn't very helpful. Luckily, I have something that might work a bit better. While this might look like a jar of water, it definitely is not. Acetone is a colorless, flammable solvent. I use it to clean metal before welding. It's also great for dissolving plastics, rubber, and some adhesive, but not so great for dissolving metal, glass, or body parts. We should be able to get rid of all the exterior plastic material while leaving the interior metal structure inside the card intact. RFID or radio frequency identification chips don't need an internal power source to work. It can power itself from the incoming radio waves from the reader, so there won't be any batteries or power source inside the card. It's pretty interesting stuff. After about 40 minutes in the acetone, we get this quite fantastic, furry, frayed, freaky-looking plastic monstrosity. It's not quite where we want it yet, so I'll put it back in to marinate for a bit longer. After another 40 minutes, we can see the internal wire structure start to emerge from the dissolving plastic that's sinking down to the bottom. The copper portion we can see inside the jar is indeed the antenna, and the chip we see is the brains of the operation, holding the encrypted key information used to unlock and start the car. Only Tesla can copy or duplicate these cards, which is good for security, and it's nice they have fair, cheap pricing on these cards since the technology is super common and super cheap. Let's see if it still works on the car without the plastic shell.
And it even lets me drive the car.
So obviously that antenna around the chip is pretty important, all these copper wires. We can see that it currently locks the Tesla right now. Let's fold it in half and see what happens.
Let's give a little fold right here. Kind of just seeing what our options are with this thing. So that worked. Give it another fold.
So I've tried this multiple ways, and the antennas going around the outside of the card are important, the orientation of them. If I keep on folding this over like a figure eight and folding it in half, it works just fine. But if it's a scrambled mess, it won't work at all. So it does depend on how the wires are shaped when you're putting it up against the car. Kind of interesting.
So overall, I'm pretty pumped with how this turned out. This is what's inside a Tesla Model 3 keycard. You know, who would have thought? There's a lot of copper and a little RFID chip. It's nice that these things are super cheap, usually less than $10, which is a lot different than modern gas-powered vehicles where the key is programmed and it costs hundreds of dollars to replace. So Tesla wins in the cheap key category. Plus, with Teslas, you can usually just use your phone, which everyone carries with them anyway, so it works out pretty nice. I'm excited to see what fun things we can do with the technology inside of this. Now that it's not the shape of a card, we can literally bend it and shape it into whatever we want. We can make it into a ring, we can turn it into a bracelet, we can sew it into the side of a wallet, we can surgically implant it into the palm of our hand. Thanks again to Ben of Teslanomics for suggesting this idea. I'll leave a link to his channel so you can check it out, everything Tesla related. If you're thinking about buying a Tesla, there's 2 weeks left to get 6 months of free supercharging using someone's code. Elon Musk, the CEO of the company, decided to stop doing the referral program. So that code is going to go away and you have 2 weeks left to take advantage of it. So if you're in the market for a Tesla, 6 months of free supercharging is pretty solid. If you have any questions or any ideas on what I should do with this contraption, go ahead and leave it down in the comments. Thanks a ton for watching, and I'll see you around.